We will not continue down a path whose predictable conclusion is more violence, more terror, and the very real threat of Iran's nuclear breakout. That is why I am directing my administration to work closely with Congress and our allies to address the deal's many serious flaws so that the Iranian regime can never threaten the world with nuclear weapons.
That was President Trump last year explaining why he would not certify that Iran had been in compliance with the Obama-era nuclear agreement. The president now says he will announce whether the U.S. will remain in the deal on Tuesday at 2 p.m. at the White House. Weijia Jiang has more.
British Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson met with Secretary of State Mike Pompeo today to urge the U.S. to remain a part of the nuclear deal with Iran,
which could lead to a nuclear weapon.
Johnson did not meet with President Trump, but may have been trying to send him a message about withdrawing by appearing on Fox News.
But you've got to do that without just throwing the baby out with the bathwater, without scrapping the whole thing. Because if you do that, you have to answer the question, what next?
The agreement, brokered by the Obama administration, European allies, Russia and China in 2015, lifted sanctions on Iran in exchange for caps on its nuclear program.
This deal is the all-time worst.
President Trump has railed against it since the campaign, but American allies are hoping he will accept a side deal to address his concerns, like Iran's growing ballistic missile program. So is former Secretary of State John Kerry, who negotiated the deal. His office confirmed Kerry has strategized with foreign officials about keeping the U.S. in the agreement. Today, Mr. Trump tweeted, the United States does not need John Kerry's possibly illegal shadow diplomacy. He was the one that created this mess in the first place. A steady stream of European leaders have visited Washington, hoping to sway the president. But this was Mr. Trump with French President Emmanuel Macron late last month.
Terrible deal. It should have never, ever been made.
On state TV, Iran's president said if America leaves, it would be okay. As long as the other countries preserve the terms. He added, Americans will be the main losers.
Weijia Jiang joins me now from the White House. So, Weijia, you mentioned a side deal with American allies that would address President Trump's concerns about the nuclear agreement. Can you tell us more about that?
Well, European allies have been scrambling to try to convince President Trump to go along with this so-called side deal because that would completely preserve the language in the original deal, the JCPOA. But it would also be able to address President Trump's main concerns with that language, including Iran's ballistic missile program, the inspections at their test sites, and the sunset clause, which would allow Iran to restart some of its nuclear ambitions in 2025. The problem is that Iran has made very clear it is not willing to renegotiate or add on to the JCPOA. So even if the U.S. and European allies strike this additional deal, which, by the way, the British ambassador said just yesterday on Face the Nation that he believes could be done by the end of the week, there are a lot of questions moving forward about how it would be implemented and eventually enforced.
Well, Iran has warned of grave consequences in the past if the U.S. leaves the nuclear deal. And we heard Iranian President Rouhani say the U.S. would be the main losers if it withdraws. What are the likely repercussions for the U.S. if President Trump decides to pull out of the agreement?
Well, President Rouhani has said that he is willing to stay in the deal, even if the U.S. drops out, if all the other countries preserve the agreement. But remember, their main driving force is an economic one. It would be very difficult for Iran to continue getting all the benefits out of this deal if the U.S. were to withdraw and effectively reimpose sanctions on countries that do business with Iran. So you can imagine the sort of economic chaos that it could create. And so President Rouhani also added that if what we want is not fulfilled, we have our own legal and lawful path and have our own plans, without elaborating about what those plans are and what that path could be. And so he has not been clear about what potential consequences could be. But certainly the U.S. could end up shouldering a lot of blame if, in fact, this creates a huge economic crisis there in that area.
Well, at Monday's press briefing, Sarah Sanders responded to reports that former Secretary of State John Kerry has been in contact with Iranian officials regarding the nuclear deal. Here's some of what she said.
I don't think that we would take advice from somebody who created what the president sees to be one of the worst deals ever made. I'm not sure why we would start listening to him now.
Weijia, what more do we know about Kerry's activity as the Trump administration prepares to announce its decision?
Well, Kerry's office issued a statement basically defending any meetings that he's had with foreign officials about this. Remember, he was the lead negotiator on behalf of the Obama administration, and this statement included thoughts about why it was important for the U.S. to remain in the deal. We know that he also met with Iran's foreign minister, among other foreign officials, to try to find a way to keep the U.S. in the deal. What Sarah Sanders did not really answer is the president's language in that tweet, because he not only criticized Kerry for his so-called, quote, shadow diplomacy, but also said that it was possibly illegal. And so we don't know why the president is saying that perhaps Kerry has broken the law by having these meetings when, according to Kerry's office, it's absolutely natural for him to be meeting with his counterparts as a former Secretary of State to try to preserve the deal that he brokered.
Well, finally, Weijia, is there a sense of how the U.S. will move forward with its policies toward Iran if President Trump does announce his intention to leave the nuclear deal?
Right now, we're really just waiting to see what President Trump unloads tomorrow, because he has said in the past that he's willing to renegotiate. So there is a chance that he pushes for that tomorrow. And if he does not, perhaps he will finally offer some details about what a U.S. withdrawal would look like, because there are two sets of sanctions on the table. One that would go into effect, again, immediately when the deadline approaches this weekend, but there's another set in July. There's always a possibility that President Trump reimposes both at the same time, but that would be viewed as the most aggressive, hard exit from this deal. And that would also eliminate that time between now and July to have more talks with Iran to try to come to a compromise. And so right now, we're just waiting to see what he decides to do. And if he decides to leave, how he does it.
All right. Weijia Zhang at the White House. Weijia, thank you.